Our next guest, Nick Barrett, the former CEO of NPR. He says he witnessed firsthand the liberal bias in the mainstream media. Come on in, Ken Stern, president of Palisades Media Ventures and the author of that book, Republican Like Me, subtitle, How I Left the Liberal Bubble and Learned to Love the Right. Ken, I wasn't expecting this from a former CEO of NPR, which I suspect is left of center. So you're telling us that, yes, the liberal media is a kind of a cabal of leftists?
Stuart, let's actually take a step back. So first of all, okay. Thanks for having me on the show. Yeah. Let's give some context to this.
Okay.
Places like the New York Times and the Washington Post have great reporters, but they tend to be cut from the same ideological cloth and the same background.
Sure.
They live in the same Acela corridor bubble, and that has an impact on what they think is important and how they think about the stories. And the reason for my book is I think we're all living in our own bubbles. We're much more demographically and geographically isolated from the other side, and that's why I took a journey from my liberal bubble out to meet as many Republicans and understand the world from their perspective.
That's interesting, because you're right. I mean, we are ideologically split. People on the left tend to watch certain news channels and read certain newspapers. But you tried to break out of that. You went to meet Republicans. What did you find?
So I'll say I had an extraordinary experience. I went to churches and pig hunts and Youngstown, Ohio, and Pikeville, Kentucky, and met extraordinary people. And when I say I learned to love the right, I mean, I didn't have to agree with everything that everyone said, but I met extraordinary people doing extraordinary things for their communities. And the other thing I found is, look, we're an incredibly moderate country, an incredibly moderate people. People tend to gravitate toward the middle and see value and ideas from both sides. It's just not reflected in the political parties and really in the media environment.
The people that you went out to meet, church groups, pig roasts, whatever you want to say, those people are not represented in the media. They're basically flyover people. We fly over them. The coastal elites fly backwards and forwards, and they just fly over those people. But you went out deliberately to meet them, right?
Yeah, and it bursts a lot of my preconceptions about the people I would meet. Just an example.
Well, hold on a second, sir. But forgive me for this, but look, my impression is that the coastal elites look down on others. I remember this from my childhood. I was born and raised in England. I know all about class consciousness and a class-based society. I remember being looked down on as a child because I'm not in the aristocracy, and I resented it bitterly. I bet you found the same thing in those flyover people, didn't you?
Yeah, no, I think that's right. So they do, I think, resent being patronized and looked down upon. And I think that's an issue for the country. I think part is it's really easy to look down or demonize other people if you don't know them. I mean, we used to have conservative Democrats and liberal Republicans, and you mixed. One of the things I'll just tell you, Stuart, is the Washington Post did this extraordinary poll during the last election in Virginia, an evenly divided state. And they asked Clinton voters, do you have any close friends or relatives who are Trump voters? And they asked Trump voters the same thing. And over half didn't have anyone in their close circles who was for the other side. And it means we just don't know the other side. And it becomes easy to look down upon them. It looks easy to demonize them. It looks easy to think of that they're much worse than they are. We got to change that.
Okay. Good luck with that. But, sir, look, seriously, that was very interesting. Thank you very much for joining us. And we'll get a hold of that book and have a look at it. Thank you, sir. Appreciate it. Ken Stern.
Thanks, sir. Thanks for having me on the show.